$25. Terms and conditions apply. Learn more at NavyFederal.org.
Be more cyber zen. Get NordVPN. With a few simple clicks, NordVPN will block online trackers, secure your devices from malware-infected downloads, and block access to malicious websites. With NordVPN, enjoy internet without trackers, without malicious websites, without malware-ridden files. Be more cyber zen. Take advantage of our special offer now at NordVPN.com.
If you missed the Brian Bailey Show, you missed.
Blake Harrell, defensive coordinator from East Carolina. You have a team and a mindset that forces turnovers, and that's going to be a key to stay in this game, isn't it?
First of all, you got to make sure you're fundamentally sound. Don't give up the big play.
Right.
You know, don't let them have anything cheap, because that's what they do so well. You know, you make a mistake, you miss a gap, you miss a tackle, that they have the ability to take it to the house and make you pay. So that's where you got to cut that out. At some point, you're going to have to take your shot, just kind of let it go out there, and hey, we're going to have to gamble a little bit and make a play.
Tune in Mondays at noon for the Brian Bailey Show, powered by Greenville Utilities, right here on Pirate Radio.
North Carolina State Parks invites you to enjoy camping your way. With the weather changing, booking your own cabin is the perfect solution for your camping getaway. Reserve campsites or cabins today at Jones Lake, Goose Creek, and Cliffs of the News. Whether you enjoy traditional camping or air-conditioned cabins that can be rented with Wi-Fi, your next adventure can include hiking, beautiful scenery, and sunsets by the campfire. For information on booking a cabin, visit ncparks.gov.
Hey Miles, isn't it amazing to think our family has been distributing soft drinks since 1923?
It certainly is, Landon. And with that comes a lot of change. But what hasn't changed is our dedication and commitment to our customers. I'm Miles Menjes.
And I'm Landon Menjes with Menjes Bottling Group. Our family has taken great pride in refreshing our neighbors, and we are proud to have remained locally owned and operated for over a century. From our family to yours, we say thank you and are honored to be a part of this wonderful community.
Here's to 100 as we celebrate our employees and our customers all over East North Carolina. From generations before us and to future generations.
Cheers to the next 100 years.
Cheers to the next 100 years.
You've worked hard to make your business successful, and that's why it's really important to always have a bank in your corner when you need them. This is former ECU baseball player Ashley Capps from First Bank, and our experienced team of local bankers includes Lee Watson, Bonner Latham, Chris Richards, Josh Hooten, and Heath Nisbet. To get the business services that are right for your business today, come and see someone on our team at First Bank on Arlington Boulevard here in Greenville. First Bank, together with our customers, we're creating a world where individuals and communities thrive.
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Are you having a hard time participating in the activities you love due to pain? Well, then you need a good stretch or perhaps a massage. At Bodies and Balance, they offer massage therapy, assisted stretching, and Graston techniques to help provide solutions. With years of experience, the team at Bodies and Balance can create a stretch or massage program that is right for you. Mention Pirate Radio to get your first free stretch and your first massage for only $1 per minute. Call 916-4530 to get on the schedule, or you can visit them online at Bodies and Balance.com.
The convenience of Pitt Greenville Airport is waiting just outside your front door. Service is back, so you're connected to destinations worldwide through flights from American Airlines. Plan your next trip. Book your flights today at flypgv.com or aa.com.
Good news, business travelers. PGV is adding a new early morning flight starting in September. Book today at AA.com and be on time for that connection in Charlotte. Fast, convenient, and close to home, PGV has American flights perfect for your next trip. And now a new early morning flight. PGV, where the Pirates fly.
Defense! Defense!
What are you doing?
You haven't heard? Carolina Hardscapes has the best defense in Pitt County. And you know defense wins championships.
What? No. They have the best fence company in Pitt County.
Wait, they do fencing now?
That's right. Just give them a call at 364-1201 and they'll get the job done right. And don't forget, they still do patios, pools, and mulch.
Wow, now that's a championship caliber company. Carolina Hardscapes. Enjoy the outdoors.
This is Pirate Radio, WGHB Farmville, 1250 and 92.7 FM Greenville, WDLX Washington, 930 and 104.1 FM Washington.
Can you be quiet, please? Thank you.
Welcome to Pirate Radio Live.
How's everybody doing? East Carolina girls are the best in the world.
Booty, 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 booty everywhere.
Clip. Hey, man, good to see you, brother.
You got
to
give me a sack, Chandler. Give me a sack.
Sack!
Yes.
How about those friggin' pirates?
It's a me, Amanda Garcia.
Puedes pintar este violeta.
Y'all are intimidating guys. I'm saying y'all are famous. Y'all are celebrity-type guys, and that's intimidating.
Now live from the Pirate Radio Studios in the heart of the Pirate Nation, here is your host, Clip Brock.
All right, welcome in to Pirate Radio Live. It is party day. Looking forward to that tonight, and looking forward to a fun show, talking a lot of football here on the program on this Thursday afternoon with Shirley Rhodes alongside the Chan Man, Chandler Honeycutt, already fanning himself. He has worked so hard today. So Chandler, have a sit, relax, and produce this program the way you know how. On Pirate Radio 92.7 FM in Greenville, 104.1 in Washington. You can find us on 1250, 930 online, pr927fm.com. And watch the show, be a part of the show on Facebook Live and YouTube. We have folks hanging out there. But a few likes, but no comments. So, hey, football is here. We got some games tonight. We'll talk about that coming up in a moment. Ken Wadlington will join us to catch us up on the high school football schedule with the weather rolling in. Some games were going to be played on Thursday. Looks like we're going to have pretty much a traditional Friday night of high school football. We'll run down some of the games with Ken Wadlington coming up in just a moment. ECU Hall of Famer Marcus Crandall will join us coming up at 4 o'clock. We got the big man on campus, Jeff Nadeau, joining us to break down week one coming up in hour number one. We'll have two week one breakdowns for you. One in hour number one with Nadeau, and one in hour number three with Emory Hunt from CBS Sports HQ. We watch him a lot on TV while we're doing the show here in the afternoons, and always like talking football with Emory, so he'll be on later on in today's show. Also expecting Ken Knox from Chairman of the Board to drop by, one of two Kens who will join us on today's program. He's supposed to be coming by in hour number two to get you ready for Chairman of the Board coming up tonight at the Pirate Radio Football Kickoff Party. We will be selling these awesome The Voice t-shirts in honor of our friend Jeff Charles, the legend. They will be $20, and all the proceeds for the party and for the shirts will go to the Jeff Charles Scholarship Fund. So we're going to have a fantastic fun night tonight. Shirley Rhodes will be there. Chandler Honeycutt will be there cutting a rug. I will be there trying to watch football. And Ken Wadlington may make an appearance as well. Hello, Ken.
What's up? I'll be there. Not may make an appearance. I'll be there.
I'm kind of shocked.
Ellerby handed me a ticket and said, would you like to come? I said, yeah, I'll be there.
As busy a man you are,
listen,
I'm a little surprised, but pleasantly surprised.
You make room in your schedule to celebrate the start of the college football season and to salute Jeff Charles.
Absolutely. 10-4 on that one. We've got some folks hanging out with us, including Elliot. Happy Thursday. Go Pirates. Looking forward to the show today, and especially the fifth quarter on Saturday.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy. And we're going to have some newcomers to the fifth quarter, so y'all be nice to Marcus Crandall and Jason Nichols. Look, I can take your anger, your hatred, your punishment after an ECU loss, but be nice to those guys week one for me. Do me a favor.
And it's Michigan, right?
It's Michigan.
Now, the number two team in the nation.
Everything, it's about perspective, Ken. Like, you lose to Michigan 42-24. You don't feel terrible about that, I don't think. You lose 73-3.
A little different.
There's going to be people upset. Yeah. So
it's about the effort.
It is. And, hey, do we want it more? If we want it more, we can win on Saturday.
If App State can do it.
I'm just practicing in my fifth quarter call. App State did indeed go and do that, Ken Wadlington, all those years ago, 2007. All right. Jamie says, do you guys run out of questions or get tired of trying to do new interviews every day with the coaching staff? Seems like it's oversaturated. Just ready for games. Yes. I'm running out of stuff to say on this show.
I'll be honest. I'm surprised there's as much availability with the coaching staff every day of the week. Usually it's, you know, your Tuesday thing and that's it. But here at ECU, you get multiple chances to talk to people. That's nice to have that availability.
We get Tuesdays and Wednesdays. Yeah. Tuesday press conference, and we'll talk to some players on Tuesday. Wednesday, we get to hear from the coordinators. Yep. So I'll definitely take that. Russ said, Clip, see what happens when depth chart is not released? It causes mayhem. All right.
Yeah, I mean.
Joey, intern Joey, says, come see me and DB at the table to sell you those beautiful shirts. That's right. Joey does more for this show when he's not here than when he is here. But Joey, we thank you for being a part of the program. And that's right, DB and Joey will be slinging shirts tonight, so go see them. And tell our interns how great of a job they're doing. We got some great interns this year, so excited about that. Brian Bailey will definitely be stealing him soon. In fact, I've already seen him talking to Danny Beal, trying to get him to NCT.
No question. He might try to give him a job. We're short a few people.
All right, let's get to our Fleet Feet rundown, brought to you by Fleet Feet. Ken, have we asked you your shoe size?
I don't think you have.
Matt, do you mind?
Take a guess.
I'm going to say you're a good 10 and a half, 11.
9.5, 10.
Okay. Yeah. I was in the ballpark.
Depends on the brand.
You can find out your exact size, your arch width, your arch height with that 3D foot scanner over at Fleet Feet, the great one-on-one service. They can take care of you at 207 East Arlington Boulevard in the old Gordon's Golf location. Fleet Feet, they run for you. Hopefully you got some comfortable shoes tonight.
Got your shag shoes on.
That's right. Chandler, you ready to go? You ready to shag? He gives me a head nod. He's busy. All right, go. Look, you work. Don't worry. We got it covered on the air. Russ was referring to a comment that I made on some website that we don't talk about on the show. And no, it's not like an adult website. It's
Name Redacted?
Name Redacted's website. Yeah, it was a comment I made on Hoist the Colors. And like anything on a message board these days, the comment, the thread is about a depth chart, and it ends up with right wing people and left wing people going crazy about something.
Every message board, every no matter sport, the topic. Every situation in America, that's what it comes down
we're
to.
We're literally talking about an ECU depth chart, and you got people losing their minds. Oh man, it really gets to me.
America.
Ken, how about a little Thursday night look over at the slate tonight, including a team in the state of North Carolina, NC State, kicking off their season against the UConn Huskies.
Yeah.
I don't know much about State, so I'm just going to go off what I know about the Dave Doran tenure and say they're going to go
8-5.
Yeah, 7-5, win a bowl game, 8-5.
Yeah.
All right.
Listen, I think there's some optimism in West Raleigh this year. You got Brendan Armstrong, who had a pretty good career at Virginia.
I liked him at Virginia, although
he can sling the rock as a lefty.
What happened last year?
Yeah, didn't have a great year, but the whole team didn't have a good year.
No.
And then obviously the season ended in tragedy, and hope for the best for Virginia this year. But Armstrong can play. He can rack up some yards in a hurry. He comes in there with a new offensive coordinator who was his offensive coordinator.
Robert and I, Ruff's buddy. Yeah.
And the defense returns six or seven guys, including Peyton Wilson. I mean, I think State's going to be pretty good. I see them cracking the top 25 at some point. Definitely if they win their first two games, because they play on the road at UConn. Then they got Notre Dame at home next week.
I love doing this with another newsman. I'm not going to say his name.
Let's say it.
Let's say his name is Bobby South.
Bobby South. Yeah.
Bobby South. Likes to
he also had one show. What's it called?
Likes to I think it's something like the press coverage.
The Blitz.
Old Bobby South and I like to talk about, all right, State's going to beat UConn. They'll beat Notre Dame and lose at Virginia. Or they'll beat Clemson, beat Miami, lose at Wake Forest. Like, they love to win one they shouldn't and lose one they shouldn't.
Yeah. I think the Pack will be good. They'll challenge for the top four or five spots in the ACC, I think.
All right. That is coming up tonight, 7:30 CBS Sports Network. Florida at Utah, the Urban Meyer Bowl.
This game's going to be a real. Where did Urban Meyer start his college coaching career?
Bowling Green, my friend.
Yes, he did indeed.
I'm a sports
shout out
trivia
Wood
host.
County, Ohio.
This game's going to be a real grind tonight.
Yeah,
see,
it should
that's
be.
The, yeah, it should the be. Joke I wanted to get in.
I don't. I don't know anything about either one of these teams. So.
All right, fair enough. We'll move on.
But I will by week five.
Matt Rhule is back.
Yeah, he is.
As we said on the show yesterday, Wager McGee likes Nebraska, and I'm scared to bet on Matt Rhule, but betting on Matt Rhule in college is a little bit different than betting on Matt Rhule in the pros. He has been fantastic as a college coach.
But can he bring Nebraska back?
I don't think Nebraska's ever going to be what they were when we were growing up.
No. I mean, it was a different day and age with old Tom Osborne and was it Tommy Frazier?
Tommy Frazier, Lawrence Phillips, yeah. Eric Crouch. Remember him?
Crouch.
At some point, kids started to realize, why the hell am I going to go to school at Nebraska when I can go to all these other places?
My now former coworker, Garrett Short, is from Indiana, Illinois area, and he just talks about how just depressing and awful Nebraska is.
As
if anyone's
state,
listening and watching from Nebraska, we don't mean to disparage it.
I've never been.
But he was like, man, it's the worst place in the world.
I hate to go off topic here, especially with sports, but how about that scene last night with the volleyball game? Yep. That was pretty cool.
90,000+.
Over 92,000 for that volleyball game.
Largest crowd for a women's sporting event in the world ever. That's amazing.
Pretty electric.
Chandler, I don't want you to ever apologize for bringing me a did you see to the show. Remember?
Did you see?
I gave you full, availability to do that. And that was a great example of it. So thank you. Jamie says, Miami of Ohio, school of what former NFL quarterback? Jamie, what kind of show do you think this is? You think this is like Fisher Price, My First Sports Radio? Get out of here, man.
It's Miami this weekend, though. That's kind of cool.
That it is.
It's good, like the Spider-Man meme. They're pointing at each other.
I'll do you one better, Jamie. You want to ask me a stupid Ben Roethlisberger question? This is the kind of trivia I like.
I got a Ben Roethlisberger question. Where do you play high school football?
Pennsylvania.
It's about 20 miles south of Bowling Green, Ohio.
Yeah, because he was like, as a quarterback, his record in the state of Ohio was stupid because he always won with the Steelers. He won a lot at Miami and in high school as well, I guess. Yeah,
he played at Findlay High School in Findlay, Ohio.
Jamie's talking to the chat, not me. Sorry, I didn't mean to impose on y'all's conversation.
We already know where Big Ben went to school.
Hey, what Super Bowl winning head coach, active head coach, played wide receiver at Miami of Ohio? There you go, chat boys. Run with that. All right. And also coming up
Sean
tonight.
McVay.
Yes, that's correct.
Oh, yep. Okay, cool.
Look at this guy. Look at this guy over here. Good stuff. All right, Ken. Let's get to the high school slate. We got D.H. Conley football coming up Friday night against.
It's supposed to be tonight.
Yeah.
They're headed to Wilson. I forget which Wilson they're playing.
I think they're on the hunt.
They're on the hunt at Wilson Hunt. James B. Hunt High School. Yes, yes.
So that'll be coming up Friday night. We'll have that for you after the high school huddle with Morgan Ehlers. Brian Bailey is passing the keys. He's saying, all right, son, don't let me down. Ken Watlington hosting Touchdown Friday.
Thoughts and prayers. send them my way. No, it's going to be great. We actually ended up with a few extra games than we expected for Friday night because originally a lot of them were moved to Thursday to try to get an early start on the Labor Day weekend. But with the storm, even though it's probably going to be all right for football tonight, everybody kind of moved their games forward. So we got a bunch of games coming your way from all over Eastern North Carolina all the way down to Wilmington. It's going to be a lot of fun Friday night.
What games are you looking forward to, Ken?
We got a really interesting game here in Pitt County that you wouldn't think would be a marquee matchup, but it's going to be our game of the week. South Central
2-0.
2-0, headed up Highway 11 to take on North Pitt at 1-0.
Yeah, what was that? Did they have a built-in off week, week two? Or?
I guess so. Everybody gets a bye week, and I guess theirs was early in the season.
All right. You're right. Kind of a big game that you didn't have maybe a few weeks ago, right?
And it's such a cool story with South Central. They've been down in football the last couple of years, but they know how to play some basketball down there in Winterville. And, well, guess what happens? The guy who won them a state championship in basketball, also the athletic director, named himself the football coach. So Chris Cherry, also a graduate of Plymouth High School in Plymouth, North Carolina, like myself. So we just know how to turn out winners.
Chris Cherry did a series of interviews, and then he set a mirror in a chair and interviewed himself. You're the man for the
and
job.
And now they're 2-0 if they get the win tonight. Tomorrow night.
3-0, you're feeling good as you head into conference play.
And you got a tough, tough conference slate, so get all the wins you can. Yeah,
Havelock, Newbern, Rose. Yeah. And there's a murderer's row in that conference.
All right, so a big Friday night. Check out Ken Watlington, and I guess no Brian Bailey, no Garrett Short. I forgot about the Garrett Short.
We've got a total team player, our weekend news anchor, Aaron Jenkins, is going to be our reporter for the game of the week. She'll get out there. She'll get the good awesome. Highlights, the great post-game interviews. She'll knock it out the park.
All right, Ken, good stuff, man. Yes, sir. We're going to go ahead and let you run because you're going to work, you're going to party, you're going to work. You got a lot going on today.
There's one thing we didn't talk about, though, the biggest game of the night.
Does it involve the Braves?
It does. The Atlanta Braves and Spencer Strider at the Los Angeles Dodgers. It is an NLCS preview.
How many games are we on the Dodgers?
I believe 4 or 4.5.
How about John Gilbert told me yesterday during the break? I wish I'd have paid attention more. Spencer Strider grew up down the road from where he did. Strider's from Columbus, right? There's a connection somewhere.
So I believe what I heard was that Strider's wife and his daughter were friends in school.
Yeah.
And I believe they were in, I believe his daughter was in the wedding of Spencer
and
Strider.
And she has stayed there in Atlanta at his place and stuff. And so.
Pretty cool. He might be the Cy Young winner.
He really,
he's got to get his ERA down over the next month or so, but he's got the strikeouts. He's leading the majors in wins.
There's a buddy of mine, Jake, that goes to sports trivia, cinder blockhead, very smart guy. But I think it was the first week of the season said, you know, Strider leading the league in strikeouts, you get pretty good odds on that. And I was like, yeah, cool. Wish I'd have taken it.
Ding, 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 ding.
That's a big winner.
And it's not even close.
Yeah, right. He's running away with it. Yeah. Ken, thanks for hanging out. We'll see
Appreciate
you tonight,
it. Can't wait for tonight. Thanks
right.
for having me.
All right. There is Ken Watlington. We'll take a break, come back. Jeff Nadeau going to join us. Let me do a quick rundown. We got a Michigan fan in the chat.
Go Blue.
Joel says, I expect ECU to play well. They have proven to be a well-coached team in the past. We may be missing 3 starters in the secondary.
All right,
Mason,
all right.
Light them up. Elliot says, is our radio announcer permanent or here till they find someone else? Jim Zoki is the interim announcer for ECU football.
Until Clip takes over.
That's right. Well, there is a big push to get Chandler Honeycutt as the new voice of the Pirates. At least by one guy I talked to in the parking lot earlier.
Yeah. Was that guy Chandler?
No.
It wasn't me.
It was actually a real man.
Human being.
A real human being. All right, let's take a break. Elliot says, my high school coach left us and went to Conley in the 90s to be the head coach of football. His name is Steve Kraft. Wonder if me and if anybody knows him. Yes, I know him, and I'm friends with his son, who is also Steve. Thank you for that, Elliot. Back with you after this.
Washington's favorite place to eat and where all the locals go is Down on Main Street. Down on Main Street's famous weekday lunch specials are only $7.99. Stop by for the house salad with grilled chicken, the half club sandwich with chips, or everyone's favorite, the fried shrimp plate. After work, Down on Main Street is the perfect spot for dinner and a drink on the patio. Join Down on Main Street every Wednesday for half price wings from 4 to close. Down on Main Street on Main Street in historic downtown Washington.
Go Pirates!
It's the summer shopping season at Brown & Wood here with Jeff Stein. Jeff, I've noticed a lot of great GMC pickup trucks on the lot.
Yes, sir. We have 2500s and 1500s in stock and the all-new 3.0 Duramax diesel. We earn 30 extra trucks on allocation, so go online, brownandwood.com, or stop in, build your truck, we'll get it coming for you. Brown & Wood, voted number one by the customer in Greenville. 4 brands, 3 generations, 2 rooftops, and 1 goal, to make sure you leave a happy customer.
Pizza, subs, slice, ice.
Jenny, what are you doing?
Just letting the Pirate Nation know that Cucinella's is now open in downtown Greenville, across from Sub Dogs. Did you know Cucinella's is open every day with $6 lunch specials, slices all day, beer, wine, and their famous homemade gelato? Plus, if you're busy, use DoorDash for Cucinella's delivery, and Cucinella's is open late night, Friday and Saturday. Cucinella's on 5th Street in downtown Greenville. Go Pirates!
Be sure to check out David Price Construction for all of your commercial or custom residential renovation and building needs. Run by ECU alumni, David Price Construction specializes in commercial projects, maintenance on facilities, and large-scale residential renovations and additions. Proud to be voted the Remodeler of the Year by the Home Builders Association of Raleigh-Wake County in 2018 and Best Business Commercial Remodel Project winner for 2020. David Price Construction, the proud ECU Home Services partner.
Hey, John, I see your new system's having issues already.
Yeah, I used the other guy with an AC brand I've never heard of.
You should have used Delcor, John. They install train. It's hard to stop a train.
I know, but the other guy was cheaper.
Cheaper isn't better, John.
I know.
Don't use the other guy. Call Delcor. For a limited time, buy a new train system and pay 0% interest for 12 months. Visit Delcor.com for more details. Delcor, the service professionals.
Cutco's Sports Bar and Restaurant, located in the old Professor O'Cool's location, has daily lunch specials from 11 to 5, including their famous $1 wing special Monday through Wednesday all day long. Cutco's has entertainment every Tuesday with Country Western Night and karaoke on Thursday starting at 8. Take advantage of their weekly fresh fruit margarita specials and be sure to try the best Philly ribeye steak rolls in town while you're at it. Cutco's Sports Bar and Restaurant, Greenville's Diamond in the Rough. Check them out on Facebook for more information. Go Pirates!
I'm Donald Stocks, owner of PIP Marketing Signs Print. We are your one-stop shop for just about anything printed. If we're not your go-to printer, please give us a call at 355-1636. We have over 80 five-star Google reviews and want you to be our next more than satisfied and well-pleased customer. Check us out at growitpip.com or stop in to see us at 3185 Mosley Drive in Greenville. PIP. Where business goes to grow.
The time to save is now during Bostick Sug Furniture's incredible Labor Day savings event. Low, low prices on in-stock furniture and mattresses ready for immediate delivery. Look for hot buy savings store-wide on Lazy Boy recliners, sofas, and sectionals. Experience your best sleep and save on a comfortable new mattress. Plus, get up to 60 months special financing. It's the biggest sale of the season with the lowest prices of the season. The Labor Day savings event on now at Bostick Sug Furniture.
This is Brian Bailey, host of The Brian Bailey Show, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 1 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour is brought to you by Pirate Water. Get ready to party, pirates. Go to drinkpiratewater.com to find your new treasure. 21 and older only. Pirate Water. Why be yourself when you can be a pirate? Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Grab your amigos and head to Chico's for the best Mexican food and fun in Greenville. Come and enjoy favorites like shrimp tacos, steak and chicken fajitas, burritos, enchiladas, ACP, and more. Follow Chico's on Facebook and Instagram for daily updates. For Mexican food and fun, it's got to be Chico's for dine-in or to-go. Now let's head back in to PRL. Here's Clip.
Back with you, Pirate Radio Live on a Thursday party time. Pirate Radio football kickoff party going on tonight. This is going to be the coolest temperature Pirate Radio football kickoff party of all time. There is a football cool nip to the air outside.
And the blue skies are starting to open up a little bit.
Hey, you're my blue sky. You're my sunny day, as the Allman Brothers once said. Let's head out to the Pirate Radio Live line. Joining us, the big man on campus, Jeff Nadeau. Football is here. Big man, how you doing?
Great. How are you?
Hey, fired up, ready to go. We got some games tonight we'll touch on, but East Carolina and Michigan Saturday at the Big House, Jeff. And at last check, it was a 36-point line, I believe, in that football game for the Pirates and the Wolverines. Total sitting in the low 50s. Jeff, look, I'm 5 minutes down the road from this the team and the stadium, and we cover it, and we don't know a whole lot about this offense. Mike Houston has been hush-hush about everything, including a depth chart and a starting quarterback. It's going to be Mason Garcia, but just a ton of unknowns on that side of the ball. So somebody like you looking for intel, probably has some trouble getting it from the Pirates as well, so you got to go off of what you know. I think the defense will be pretty good this year, Jeff. I don't know if that'll show up on Saturday when they take on Michigan, but I don't know. What's your take on the Pirates and Wolverines?
I think the total's a bit low. And look, all due respect, I don't think much is going to be contributed from East Carolina Pirates. However, I mean, Michigan in non-conference last year got into the 50s in every game, I believe.
Yeah.
One was maybe 49, but I mean, 52 is not crazy. Here's the issue that I have, though, and I'm just going to be frank. I mean, I wonder if ECU can score in this game. I'm being honest. I don't know where that's going to come from. I mean, look, if this is last year's team, obviously I wouldn't say such a thing. But I really have to wonder. I mean, Michigan's defense is stupendous. I mean, they're one of the best in America. I wonder about Mace Christie. I've said to you, and I'm not saying anything you just don't know down there, but I mean, it concerns me that Mason Garcia is, you know, look, he's not a freshman or something. I mean, he's a quarterback that's been there a year or two. I mean, he probably should have won the job, no? I mean, that seems a bit concerning me. I guess it's his job, but it didn't seem like it was a guarantee, and that's concerning against a really good team, you know, in the Big House that generally crushes teams like this. This game screams like 51-7 to me. I maybe look towards a ECU team total under. I just don't know if they can move the ball.
Yeah, and boy, Vegas does not have East Carolina scoring many points in this game when you look at a 36-point spread and a 51.5 total. So if the Pirates do score, double digits, it would be, I guess, surprising if you look at this number. So, I don't know. I think they can stick around, but I don't know. We shall see. There's some other games I want to ask you about, Jeff. We'll bounce around, and then we'll get to some that you like tonight and this weekend. But my favorite game of that's not really a headliner is UTSA-Houston. I think there could be, you know, some points in that game, but I've also kind of talked up UTSA this summer, so I want to see them do well in year one of the American, just for my sake. They are road favorites against the Cougars, against Dana Holgorsen's guys. What do you think about that matchup?
Yeah, I think the numbers telling, right? I mean, you have a Houston team that obviously loses Clayton Tune. They lose Tank Dell. They actually gain Malik Fleming, which is interesting, who was at ECU, as you know.
Yeah.
But you look at defensively, I still think they're a team that's going to have some issues. I look at UTSA. I think this is the strongest UTA team they've had. They're playing in massive revenge. If you watched this game last year, this game
was
three overtimes, and then they lost on the going for two. So that's something that I think it really kind of bodes into this. Plus, throw in the fact that, as you said, this is a road game, and they are a favorite. Keep in mind, they didn't open favorite, though. This has been bet up. Sharp money's all over UTSA. I agree. I bet UTSA. I love them here. I'm very high on this team. I think they are the best team in the AAC.
You've got them winning it. The team that won it last year was Tulane. They got South Alabama coming up on Saturday night. And Tulane's got the number beside their name, and they deserve it from what they did last year. And coach coming back, quarterback coming back. But I know the South Alabama team, they know how to win, Jeff. And the number is inside of a touchdown here. Is Tulane on upset watch Saturday night? Boy, that was such a good question. I got Nadu stumped. Hopefully he'll call us back. Oh, there you are. Jeff, you there?
I might have hit the mute button.
Oh, okay. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I think Tulane is obviously right up there with SMU and UTSA. But South Alabama's pretty good as well. I have them as the top team in the Sun Belt. Carter Bradley's back. You know, the run game is really good down there. They can move the football. They almost upset UCLA last year. I think if you can grab a 7, I think this really screams kind of it's similar to me with this game tonight between Nebraska and Minnesota. I just think it's too many points. I think, I think USA is a team. Now, my issue here is there are certain individuals that have bet this game that I'm the same side of.
Okay.
So I'll just say that. But, I think, I would lean maybe money line here. Maybe get some bang out of your buck here.
All right, let me ask you about three teams in the state of North Carolina, Jeff, all involved in interesting games. And one is tonight, NC State, UConn. Interesting because, you know, State comes into the season with kind of what they always are. They'll win seven or eight games. Dave Doran will be on the hot seat 1 week, then win two in a row, and then he'll lose one. That's kind of what they do. It's interesting because UConn has had a bit of a resurgence, and State is a two-touchdown favorite tonight on the road in East Hartford. Any thoughts on that matchup or those two teams?
I didn't really have much on this one. I think, you know, NC State is a team that I think offensively is going to look pretty good as usual. They have Robert and Nye as the new offensive coordinator, new quarterback down there as well. I feel like Brennan Armstrong was a guy at Virginia that 2 years ago was terrific.
Yeah.
And I had a coordinator there. They should move the ball with ease. But UConn's always pesky. I mean, obviously a group last year that very much surprised. I don't think any of us thought they could get the 6 wins, and they found a way to do it. I kind of had this at like 34-17. I kind of like their team total, NC State, a little bit. I feel like they get into the 30s here. Number's not great, but it is under 31, which helps. I kind of like that. I mean, they faced UConn last year, dropped 41. I think this is probably a better offense. So I kind of, if I'm going to play anything, I would just kind of focus on NC State's offense. I think they move the ball. No, interesting clip. You know, 83% of the actual money coming in is on UConn. This number was 16. It's been bet down.
So, wow.
You know, sharper money's coming in and taking the home dog here.
All right, game in the state of North Carolina. Charlotte coming up Saturday night. North Carolina, South Carolina. How about a total in the mid-60s for two talented quarterbacks, Jeff? Will any defense be able to stop the other? And you got Drake May, Spencer Rattler. What do you think about the Carolinas going at it on Saturday night?
Yeah, and it's more likely that a stop comes from South Carolina. I actually think their secondary is very good. I think they have a good defense. And in these types of games, this is where you can make some extra profit by just taking money line. I don't really care that much about the 2 points. I'll just take the money line, get some extra juice back, play it at, you know, 120, plus 120. I think South Carolina goes in and wins this game. This is a great game, going to be a fun one on Sunday night. You know, I obviously love Drake May, and you know, I think he's a great quarterback. But the truth is, I just don't really trust their defense. I know South Carolina always has a quality secondary, and they have one of the best in the SEC. I'll take Spencer Rattler, big stage, Shane Beamer, like this spot for them.
All right, and one more involving the team in our state, Jeff, and that would be Duke. They get the Monday night game, the Monday night kickoff game at home against Clemson. There'll probably be a lot of orange in Wallace Wade Stadium coming up on Monday night. You know, Clemson is obviously an ACC championship contender, but I've seen people put them in their four. I think they could potentially get there at the end of the year. Although Duke, you talked about how surprising some of these other teams were last year. Duke, maybe the most surprising team in the country when they're able to win 9 games last year. Can they give Clemson a fight coming up on Monday night?
I think it depends what you mean by fight. Like, do I think they hang maybe within 17? Yeah, probably. I think at points it could be close, but I think this number is just too low. I think anything under 14, I think you have to play Clemson. I mean, I kind of had it like 41-24. I think Clemson's offense is going to be sick this year. I've said before, I very much like this team. I bet them a while ago to win the whole thing. A new offensive coordinator, kind of moving on from Ulagalele. You have Klubnik. This is his team now. I think defensively, they're really strong. I think, you know, we've kind of forgotten about Clemson for the last year or two. They're back now. And I think they kind of set the stage here on Monday night. They're the only game. They're kind of that standalone game. Yeah, I like Clemson. I think this number's too low. You look at it opened 10.5. It's been bet up. I think they just made a bad price on this game. Clemson, if it stays under 14, I would be very interested.
They do gave us a week one pick, week zero. And I believe, Jeff, was that Baylor, Texas State over? Is that the one you told us last week?
It is. You know, that number is just bet up. I think it's the best over on the board. There are some other good overs. I'll give you another play that I like. It's kind of off the beaten path. It's tomorrow evening. I like Hawaii on the money line, plus 135 against Stanford. Don't really understand why Stanford's a road favorite, especially in Hawaii. Couple things here. I think Hawaii is a better team. Stanford is not vintage Stanford. This is not David Shaw and Andrew Luck and you know, Toby Gerhardt. This is a bad roster with a first-year coach that's from the FCS. You now have to go on the road to Hawaii, a team that's already played with a quality quarterback, probably could have got the win if they played, you know, maybe five, 6 more minutes. And you're playing in a place right now that has a lot of people that are looking for an outlet outside of their life. And Hawaii football, if you follow it, they very much love football in that area. I think Hawaii emotionally plays for that state. I'm not big on emotional stuff, Clip, if you know me, but I think this is a great spot for Hawaii. I really like them here. I think they win this game. I'll take the plus 135 with Braden Scheger and the boys. Keep in mind, Clip, just want to point this out. Last 5 games at home, Hawaii's 5-0 against the spread. So if you like the 3, grab it. I'm going to play a little harder.
That'll be late night coming up on Friday night. Jeff Nadeau joining us on the Pirate Radio Live Line. Nadeau, we've got our Bud Light pregame tailgate kicking off 8 a.m. Saturday morning. In the past couple of years, we've been able to hook up with you on Saturdays. So I'll see if we can do that again if you're not busy on Saturday morning.
Well, you know, Cliff, I would tend to be busy for a lot of people, but for you, I would always be available.
What a guy. What a guy.
Beautiful woman in my life. I'm always available.
Yeah, awesome. Nadeau, anything to plug? I know you always got a lot going on, sit-down podcast and otherwise. What you got going on now?
Yeah, I would just say follow me on Twitter, at Jeff Nadeau. I have some, you know, some all sorts of content that I'm doing privately. I got one that I'm kind of debuting soon, so... You know, keep abreast. I'm just staying busy. I got all sorts of things going on. So thanks for having me as always. I'll talk to you Saturday.
Yes, sir. We'll talk to the big man on campus Saturday following a Thursday night and Friday night of football. And didn't really dive into it there, but sounds like Wager McGee. He is on the side of Matt Rhule tonight. Chandler, let me ask you, because I'm gonna tell Wager and tell Nadeau. And betting on Matt Rhule in college is a lot different than the pros. He has been a great college coach. As a Panthers fan, can you stomach taking Nebraska in a football game? Or do you have too many ill thoughts still towards your former head coach?
I guess the answer is that I can stomach it because I took the Cornhuskers.
Big Red. Yeah, he's had
plus the points.
The black shirt defense at Nebraska, you and I, black shirts, it's all lining up.
Yes, sir.
Well, I like corn. You like corn?
Yeah. I love corn. Cream corn is the best.
Really?
I love cream corn.
Huh.
No, Shirley?
No.
I wouldn't say it's the best. I mean, I'm a Cobb guy.
I'm a total Cobb girl.
If you
you're a Cobb girl.
If that didn't pick up on Mike, Shirley said, I'm a total Cobb girl. So there you go. Rara says, this feels like the first year without Shane Carden, with Pirate Nation really not knowing what to expect out of this team. I would agree with that. Feels like the first year without Dominique Davis, when we were getting to know Rio Johnson and Shane Carden. It's exciting. I guess different. Anytime there's something different, it's exciting, but it's a little, makes you a little nervous not knowing your
personnel.
Yeah. And like, who's going to be the man?
But I feel like we know him, but we don't know him well enough because he's been here so long.
And speaking of Mason Garcia.
Yes. And we've seen him starting a game, but you have to date back 3 years ago during COVID. So, I mean, there's just so you have to think there's so much growth in his game since then. And we shall find out on Saturday, come noon.
All right. You smell that? Todd said, I can smell college football in the air. And what a scent it is. Just bottle that up for me. And I want to spray
it. Send it my way.
Yeah, I want it year round.
Can you actually split up that into 2 bottles? And can I get one, please?
Put a little on the neck.
Yeah. Oh, what's that smell?
Spray a little in the car.
What's that cologne? College football.
It is exciting. Isn't that crazy? You ever think about like how crazy it is, like what can affect your mood and just your overall outlook on things. Strangers running around in matching shirts and pants, wearing helmets, hitting each other, gets us so excited. It's kind of weird when you think about it, right?
It is weird. Especially if you're from an outside world and you come in here and you're like, you're excited about this? Well, yeah, I am.
Yeah, this is like...
And then come November, we're going to be excited about strangers in shorts and sleeveless shirts.
Yeah.
Dribbling a basketball.
Just like they're out there on wood, a wood surface, just bouncing a ball up and down.
And there's two baskets.
Elevated.
Elevated.
Yeah.
10 feet in the air.
Yeah.
And we get excited about that.
We lose our minds over it. We get excited about it. We get happy about it. We get sad about it. We get mad about it.
And the most excited we get about it when it comes to basketball, there's this one month that we call it madness. March Madness. That's crazy to think about if you think about it.
Let's take a break before our minds blow. Slam off our heads, off our shoulders. When we return, we'll wrap up hour number one. Coming up hour two, we got Marcus Crandall, ECU Hall of Famer. Coming up hour three, Emory Hunt, CBS Sports HQ. A lot to go. By the way, for our YouTube audience, I hope you're sitting down. I got some real bad news for you. The show, Pirate Radio Live, will go on as planned from 3 to 6. The live chat on YouTube and Facebook will cease to exist at 5 o'clock. We're shutting her down. So, Jamie, get out all your questions. Eric, get out all your dumb jokes. You got an hour and 20 minutes to do it. We're shutting her down at 5 o'clock. You have been warned. Back with you after this.
This is Talbot Green with Integrity Home Mortgage. Are you ready and pre-approved if the home you want to purchase comes for sale today? This is a very important step when trying to purchase a home in the current market. Integrity Home Mortgage offers a wide variety of loan programs. Our team of Talbot Green, Braxton Green, and Joanne Weir has over 50 years of experience and is committed to providing you with the superior customer service you deserve.
To get started, call me, Joanne Weir, at 531-1148.
Joanne Weir and MLS 75974. For informational purposes only, Integrity Home Mortgage Corporation is an equal housing lender, NMLS 208516.
This is Dr. Chris Barsani from Orthopedic Season Sports Medicine Center. Our practice has been caring for the athletes at ECU and the residents of Eastern North Carolina for more than 35 years. Whether it's treatment for your sports injuries or it's time for that joint replacement, Orthopedic Seats provides the latest in operative and non-operative orthopedic care. We also offer on-site physical therapy and MRI services as well as walk-in urgent care on the weekends from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Call us at 757-BONE or visit us online at orthoeast.com. Go Pirates.
Pizza, subs, slice, ice.
Jenny, what are you doing?
Just letting the Pirate Nation know that Cucinella's is now open in downtown Greenville, across from Sub Dogs. Did you know Cucinella's is open every day with $6 lunch specials, slices all day, beer, wine, and their famous homemade gelato? Plus, if you're busy, use DoorDash for Cucinella's delivery, and Cucinella's is open late night, Friday and Saturday. Cucinella's on 5th Street in downtown Greenville. Go Pirates!
This is Gina from Naughty Life in downtown Washington, inviting you to come shop our restock store. We are back from market with a great selection of everything Yeti and much more. For back to school, we have Scout lunch bags and book bags in all new patterns. We also have a great selection of t-shirts, including Old Row, Southern Fried Cotton, and Local Boy. Remember, we always provide free gift wrapping with your purchase. Shopping is always fun at Naughty Life in beautiful downtown Washington on Main Street.
We're here for the booty.
Party!
Pirate Water is here. Go to drinkpiratewater.com to find Pirate Water in a location near you.
We're going places!
Pirate Water is here. 21 and older, please drink responsibly.
Attention athletes and fans. Tiebreakers is looking for all-stars. Do you know an athlete who made a game-winning play, scored an amazing touchdown, or hit a huge home run? We're scouting Eastern North Carolina for this month's most outstanding athlete. Go to tiebreakersathlete.com to nominate your favorite player for the prestigious Athlete of the Month Award. Tiebreakers, shining a light on the athletes that make Eastern North Carolina proud. Submit your nomination now at tiebreakersathlete.com.
This is John Gavigan with the Gavigan Agency. Our top priority is doing what is best for our members. Whether you are buying a new vehicle, a new home, protecting your family with life insurance, or filing a claim, our agency will be there every step of the way. Our goal is to become a trusted advisor for you and your family for all of your personal and commercial insurance needs. Give us a call in Greenville at 756-1400 for a car, home, business, or life insurance quote today, and give us the opportunity to show you the benefits of doing business with someone who cares.
Skip the cooking this week and liven up your gathering with catering from Jimmy John's. Choose from a variety of mouth-watering Jimmy John's specialties, including box lunches, tasty sides, 18 or 30-piece party boxes, or 12 packs of mini Jimmys made to order on fresh-baked bread with hand-sliced meats and fresh veggies. Pick it up or they'll set it up for you. And don't forget Jimmy John's loyalty app with a free sandwich after your first visit.
Jimmy John's, with three locations in Greenville. Order online at jimmyjohns.com. Go Pirates!
This is Garrett Sayles, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour One of Pirate Radio Live. This hour is brought to you by Pirate Water. Get ready to party, pirates. Go to drinkpiratewater.com to find your new treasure. 21 and older only. Pirate Water. Why be yourself when you can be a pirate? Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. East Plumbing, Viva Electric, and Roland Black Heating and Cooling have teamed up to form New Blue Service Group, offering Eastern North Carolina the best in plumbing, electrical, and HVAC services. Same great local team, same great local service, just a new name. For plumbing, electrical, and HVAC services, go to callnewblue.com. That's callnublue.com. New Blue Service Group, where we are redefining service excellence. Now let's head back into PRL. Here's Clip.
All right, back with you, Pirate Radio Live. Steve Hill has entered the chat. Surely he wants to hear some old sound bites.
All right.
You ready to go?
Yeah.
All right. He starts it out with Clip. Oh! Go Gator.
Go Gator.
Florida taking on Utah tonight.
Mm.
Burglary. Two little butt cheeks.
It's two little butt cheeks.
Swinging dingers.
Oh, good Lord. Where is it?
Swinging dingers.
I want me some glory hole. I got a little taco meat on my chest. It was in the men's section. All right. I'm a former long snapper. So. Ric Flair, woo! I want to shake his hand. Tell him to bring me my money. I don't think you got that one.
Old khaki pants.
Help the bear!
Dude. My guy.
Which one?
My guy.
My guy.
All right, well done, Shirley.
Thank you.
That's a nice little brain mouse exercise for Shirley Rhodes to make sure all the everything's clicking in the brain. Marcus Crandall, ECU Hall of Famer, joining us here in the Pirate Radio Studios. Marcus, how you doing, man?
I'm doing good, man. Blessed and highly favored. How about you?
I'm doing great. Football is back. Had a little appetizer with Week Zero on Saturday. We got games tonight, games on Friday, and of course East Carolina and Michigan coming up on Saturday. So a lot to be excited about.
Here we go. And it begins.
And it doesn't stop. Like, once you get in it,
right,
and you know it, of course, as a player, but on our end, we're kind of like players and coaches where you get through the game, you get through the post game, and you kind of are ready to move on to the next one. And that's what these coaches and players have to do. Mike Houston said it yesterday that they know Michigan. They've seen enough film. They've been in enough meetings. they know Michigan. He talked about the turnaround coming up Sunday, Monday, when you got to get your attention to the next team. That's when you really get into the cycle and everything goes so fast.
You know what? That's the thing about football is it's probably pretty much the only sport that where you go all week and you're thinking about one team. Then on one day, that game is done and over with, and the next day you really have to move on, and that's the hardest part.
Win or lose, right?
Win or lose, absolutely. Win or lose, because you get up there on the wins and you're excited and elated about what happened the previous day, and then you have to look at the next person, and so you can't get too excited because you got to do it all over again.
I want to talk more ECU football with you coming up in hour two, but right now, let's give some shout-outs. Shout-out to Isaiah Winstead, making the practice squad for the 49ers, and texted with him last night, and he said he this is not the top of the mountain for him, Marcus, because he said I'll be on active soon. So he's got the vision, he's got the mindset, he's not satisfied with where he's at, but man, I'm really happy for him.
You know what, you really have to have that kind of mindset, right? And trying to get that roster spot, and the more hungry you are, the coaches and players around you are going to see that.
Yeah,
they're going to. I'm sure if he has that mentality, his work ethic shows it as well. So he's doing whatever he has to do that way to get to that point. But good on him, man. Good on him not being satisfied in the way he is, where he is on the practice roster, and trying to make that active roster.
Holton Ahlers learning the life of an NFL player on the field and the business side of it, has a very good preseason, gets waived, gets picked back up on the practice squad. So we knew Pete Carroll and the Seahawks liked what they saw in Holton Ahlers, and awesome to see him getting a shot there on the practice squad.
Again, he did a really good, nice job of doing what he does best in the preseason. That's showcasing his skills, which is an all-around skill set for him. Over the years at East Carolina, I really was impressed at how well he became more accurate with the football. And then as you get older and grow in the offense, and you learn how to make plays with your legs as much as possible, I think he's going to learn when he get into the NFL. And I think Geno Smith kind of alluded to it on the sidelines in one game in regards to, all right, you take off running. Now you got to learn how to get down after you get those yardage, man, and learn when to get them, and as far as when to get down and when to try and go for that extra yard and take on a couple of hitters.
Keaton Mitchell bypassing the practice squad. He is on the 53-man roster, Marcus, and Bryce Williams, I think, said this, and Jason Nichols the other day as well. When you can do multiple things, you're valuable. And we saw what he can do running the football. Also opened some eyes on kick return. And if you can kind of save a roster spot and have a guy do both, teams love that. And I think we could see Keaton returning the opening kickoff for the Ravens.
That's right, man. The more you can do is the phrase that we used to use. The more you can do, the more opportunities you're going to get. And good on him in regards to getting back there taking those kickoffs and finding a way to hit that 53.
And Ryan Jones, East Carolina tight end, found his way in the box score, I think, one time as far as a catch goes, maybe a couple of times in the preseason. But they like what they saw in him. Obviously, a very athletic tight end, can do a number of things. And he finds himself on the practice squad as well.
Yeah, I mean, at the tight end position these days, they're getting more looks. You got the George Kittles and Travis Kelce and all those guys that are more athletic and can do multiple things on the offense in regards to being up there with the offensive line, learning the blocking schemes and all those things, and being able to implement that into his repertoire is going to be good for him. So that's probably why he's stuck on the roster.
And a couple of other Pirates, good to see Deontay Smith make the roster for the Bengals, Jaquan McMillan for the Broncos. So got Pirates in the pros. We love to see that in the NFL. And, of course, Marcus, as you know, got guys playing right now in the CFL.
Yes, indeed. Good to see, man. Good to see for the Pirates fans.
And I'm hoping Winstead can make that 53. I told him I'd buy him a jersey. I'd buy myself a Winstead jersey if awesome. He does make it. So
really, you're going to go a different shade of... Reds.
Look, I'm a Commanders guy, but I'm a Winstead guy.
Hey, I understand.
Saw some news on Shirley's Dolphins. They are beat up at the running back position, and Jeff Wilson went on the IR today. So they're down to, like, Raheem Mostert, and I want to say an undrafted rookie running back right now. Let's see. They've got Raheem Mostert and undrafted rookie Chris Brooks as their healthy running backs heading into the season. So some issues there in Miami. Looking forward, we'll talk more NFL with you next week, Marcus, and make some selections and things like that. But Cowboys, I don't know. Are you still a Cowboys fan?
I like watching all the teams.
You're just a football fan at this point.
I'm a fan of the football, all NFL, CFL. Haven't watched anything else outside of those two.
So, if anybody can beat the Chiefs this year, who are the top contenders? Of course, the Eagles played them in the Super Bowl last year. They've had some run-ins with the Bills and the Bengals over the years. Who stands in the way of Kansas City this year?
Man, I really think Baltimore is going to make a run for it this year. I think we're going to get a healthy Lamar Jackson. Their backfield is explosive. They got back after back after back at that position as far as the backups, Gus Edwards and all those guys.
And the options now at receiver, Zay Flowers.
The rookie.
I hate to do player comparisons, but when I saw him playing that Monday night against Washington, looked like little Tyreek Hill running around. He is super fast.
Absolutely.
Can get away.
Takes the top off the coverage.
They've got Beckham, if he's got anything left, which I think he probably does, Rashad Bateman, and the second best tight end in football, probably right. Mark Andrews.
That's right, man. A lot of weapons for Lamar in that position, and then himself as far as utilizing his legs as well with the RPOs and all those things that they all do, possibly, because they do have a new offensive coordinator, I believe, right? And so the offense is probably going to change a little bit. But I still foresee him using his legs as much as possible to do whatever he can do to help them get win football games.
Marcus Crandall here in the Pirate Radio Studios. He will join us hour two as well. We'll take a break as we go to break. How about this, Shirley? First time I've seen this, I don't want to say person, this being in the chat. Grimesland Bigfoot is checking in.
Interesting.
Said, I've been following Holden since his D.H. Conley days. I knew he wasn't done in Seattle. That is right. Holden Ahlers did have a Bigfoot sighting, and I guess this is that
and
Bigfoot.
And claims to have it on video, although it's kind of grainy.
It's a classic. Oh. Anytime you see a UFO or a Bigfoot video,
it's always grainy.
It's never clear.
It's always grainy.
It's half pixelated. Oh, trust me. I watch a lot of those. I guess you could label them as sci-fi or whatever, but I watch a lot of those shows, Hunting for Bigfoot and Paranormal Caught on Camera. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of UFOs and things like that.
So. I think Pete Carroll is a conspiracy guy. Maybe that's why he's keeping Holden around. They can bond on their belief in Bigfoot.
I wonder if Pete Carroll has seen the video of the Grimesland Bigfoot.
All right, let's take a break. We'll talk some Pirate football. You got questions for Marcus, myself, or comments, get them in. And we'll talk some Pirate football when we return Pirate Radio Live on a Party Thursday. Back with you after this.
Where is their live music every night?
Da buck, da buck, da buck, da buck, da buck.
Where is the place to watch football with the biggest TV in Greenville?
Da buck, da buck, da buck, da buck, da buck.
Where is their live bands every Friday and Saturday night with the best bartenders and drinks in town?
Da buck, da buck, da buck, da buck, da buck.
Located at Bell's Fork, we're open every day until 2 a.m. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram for all up-to-date info. And we will see you at da buck, da buck, da buck. Go Pirates!
I'm Sam Jones, and for more than three generations, my folks have kept the fires burning for Eastern North Carolina Whole Hog Barbecue. At Sam Jones, you'll find our smokehouse pumping out wood-fired meats cooked fresh every single day. There are no freezers at our place. Everything, and we mean everything, is made fresh daily, including our sides, sweets, and sauces. Stop in and see us, and I bet you'll be able to taste our passion in just one bite. At Sam Jones Barbecue, you'll find plenty of smoke, but no mirrors.
It's hard to forget how hot it gets around here in the summer.
Remember, the hotter it is outside, the harder your AC has to work to keep it cool inside. And the more energy it uses to keep you cool, the higher your utility bill will be. Your neighbors at GUC have tips to help you reduce your energy use, such as using fans to cool you down inside and cooking outside when you can in the summer. For more tips, go to GUC.com and look for ways to save.
Bud Light was brewed to be delicious and easy to drink beer, even when little things in life are hard, like when you're working late and happy hour has already started, but you're about to clock out and head over. Bud Light, easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Pick up Bud Light at your local retailer today. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates, and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Enjoy responsibly. Anheuser-Busch, Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Hey Pirate Nation, be sure you have the best and comfortable shoes this tailgate season with a stop at Fleet Feet. Locally owned and operated by ECU alum Chris Lunyon, Fleet Feet of Greenville provides solutions through one-on-one service to runners, walkers, and everyone in between. Fleet Feet has the tools and technology to get you in the right shoe, including a 3D foot scanner that measures arch height, width, and more. Go see them at 207 East Arlington Boulevard in the old Gordon's Golf location. Fleet Feet, they run for you. Go Pirates!
North Carolina State Parks invites you to enjoy camping your way. With the weather changing, booking your own cabin is the perfect solution for your camping getaway. Reserve campsites or cabins today at Jones Lake, Goose Creek, and Cliffs of the News. Whether you enjoy traditional camping or air-conditioned cabins that can be rented with Wi-Fi, your next adventure can include hiking, beautiful scenery, and sunsets by the campfire. For information on booking a cabin, visit ncparks.gov.
Papa John's new garlic epic stuffed crust pizza is the pizza inspired by our biggest fans. With that garlic flavor you all love.
In it, on it, with it.
Get the new garlic epic stuffed crust pizza for $13.99 only at Papa John's.
Hey Pirate fans, Papa John's is the MVP move for game day or any day. Place your order online at papajohns.com and sign up for Papa Rewards. Papa John's, better ingredients, better pizza. Go Pirates!
Do you need custom t-shirts, apparel, or promotional items for your business, organization, or event? Keep it local and print it local with University Sportswear. University Sportswear is your one-stop shop to help promote your business and always provide superior customer service. No matter what apparel you need for your team or customers, University Sportswear can make it happen. Visit UniversitySportswearENC.com for contact information. University Sportswear, the official sportswear provider of Pirate Radio. Go Pirates!
This is Pirate Radio, WGHB Farmville, 1250 and 92.7 FM Greenville, WDLX Washington, 930 and 104.1 FM Washington.
You're listening to Hour 2 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by Beauty Bar Metaspa. Do you want to get rid of wrinkles, tighten and lift your skin, smooth your skin texture, erase veins and brown spots, and get rid of unwanted hair? Are you interested in Botox or filler? Visit BeautyBarMetaspa.com to set up a free consultation. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. UBE has been an ECU tradition for over 50 years, and you can shop online anytime at PirateWear.com. UBE has the biggest and best selection of ECU sportswear and accessories for pirates of all ages. Every day is game day at UBE. Now let's head back in to PRL. Here's Clip.
All right, Big Dog in the house. What up, Big Dog?
What's up, man?
Marcus, do you see the Houston Cougars are throwing back the clock and going with the Houston Oilers look?
Yes.
What do you think?
Man, that is stellar.
You like it?
I do. It's pretty fresh. I really do. Because I think the Titans were thinking about doing that as well, I think, this year or something.
Yeah, I think they are going to go with the Oilers throwbacks. I remember Chris Johnson wearing those when he played.
Man,
they look pretty sharp.
Those are nice, man. I love those unis. One of the nicer unis back in the day, huh?
Who do you think of? Warren Moon?
Warren Moon. They had the, man, they had a lot of receivers back then.
Remember, some good randomly, receivers. Ernest Givens comes Jefferson. To mind.
Yeah.
I see his face. Wasn't Jerry Glanville the coach at one point?
Yes.
They went through Glanville, and Bum.
Bum Phillips, yeah. But I just remember Jerry Glanville because he, at the time, he was like the big character of you know, football football coaches, because, you know, most everybody was kind of straight-laced, but he was like the motorcycle-riding Elvis Presley, you know, dressing kind of guy that just was kind of out there.
I'm going to be a hater, and I'm going to say that I don't like them.
Why is that?
Because the ECU is playing them.
Well, no.
Well, not anymore.
Not that, not that, but it's that the school itself has no relevancy to the Oilers. It would be like if one of the Triangle schools just started wearing, or the University of Charlotte, if that came out in a Panther uniform.
I kind of like the city synergy stuff. I like that Pittsburgh, all of Pittsburgh's teams are all black and gold.
Now, that's cool. I don't mind that.
So, like, if the Pittsburgh Panthers did
a black and gold.
Although their color, their uniforms are some of the best now that they've gone back
now,
to the old.
Their old school uniforms, the blue, are fantastic.
Yeah, they look really good.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
All right. Jamie says, what would Marcus's emotions be going into a game like a game against Michigan? I guess saying you're playing the number two team in the country, big underdogs. Would you be anxious, nervous? How would you feel?
I would feel very excited, for one, very excited and just eager at the opportunity to for us going into their house, the big house, and with the possibility in my mind to go in there with come out of there with an upset win. And that's just the type of person I am, the type of player I was. Always looking for that underdog opportunity because of, you know, probably pretty much from where I'm from, small town and all of that. But that's my mentality. Never give up. Always looking for the challenge. And if you're in my path of my goals, let's go.
May the best man win.
Absolutely.
Jason Nichols, I said, what advice, what would you tell Mason Garcia before this game? And he said, breathe. And on that note, Jamie says, how long does it take to get settled in when you're in an environment and a big stage like that? How about you personally? Were you able to go out there, play one calm, or did it take you a few?
You know, after a couple of games, you know, coming from, you know, the small school and getting up there and playing my first game on ESPN against Syracuse, I believe after that game, things kind of slowed down for me, even though I got hurt the very next game. But I was able to kind of build up to the next season going into the first game pretty calm for the most part, but still probably a little nervous that first game. And then after that first game, my nerves start to calm down, started to feel more just excitement and just the blessing of, you know, just playing the game, being blessed to be able to be there and play the game, more so than the nerves.
Robert asking, how does an NFL team, or you can go CFL in your experience, duplicate the job of a college scout team? He says, practice squad, starters, or is it just film study walkthrough? So in college, you've got your scout team that shows you looks. How about in professional football?
Professional, it depends on the coach. It really depends on the coach. You got a lot of coaches that believe in ones versus ones all the time, and then giving the scout team a little look. But I think they balance it out a little bit more over the years, or have balanced it out over the years, where, you know, they get the ones on ones, but at the same time, you're going to get those looks with the scout team as far as what the other team is doing. So it really depends on the coach. I've been involved in multiple because I had different head coaches and coordinators, and so we did it in a lot of different ways.
Eric says, what does Marcus think about Martin County only fielding one sports team now? We went from four teams to one in less than two decades, and he says they lost their hospital as well.
Yeah, Martin General is gone. All the other sports are gone, and they combined the schools, and it's dwindling. But hopefully, you know, we get. I think the most important thing is when you have people that aren't showing up for the different sports, The interest isn't there, and so you start to lose interest as far as the having the programs around. Yeah. And so no choice, right? Hopefully we get some people or in Martin County get some more athletes involved in other sports and able to bring it back at some point.
All right, Marcus Crandall joining us here. NFL news, the Patriots are officially back. They have picked up my favorite quarterback of the 2022 NFL draft. Matt Corral is a Patriot.
He is.
Panthers got rid of him. Patriots scoop him up. He's going to be the next Tom Brady.
Wow. Is Zappe back as their backup?
Zappe got cut yesterday.
He did not get re-signed?
He re-signed to the practice squad.
He is a practice squatter.
Okay.
Yeah, because they cut like all of their quarterbacks, didn't they?
Yes. The Patriots. Malik Cunningham.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And they cut everybody, yeah. And then
Malik Cunningham was running quarterback and receiver in the same preseason game. Did he get picked up by
practice squatted by the Patriots.
Yeah. Because, like, that seems like the kind of guy Belichick would – he loves to put guys at different positions.
Used to.
Yeah.
I mean, during the Super Bowl runs, they had guys that played corner and wide receiver and
– Mike Vrabel and Teddy Bruschi going out for passes and
right.
stuff.
Right. Mm-hmm. Be goal line tight ends and fullbacks.
Right. Jamie says Clips buddy Chase Young once again hurt with a stinger.
Oh.
I haven't seen this.
I haven't either.
Chase Young, he's practicing, doing everything we need him to do. Oh, here we go.
Well, hopefully that's not too serious. Yeah. Stinger, I mean,
status,
it can be.
His week one status is in question. His status is always in question.
How is old Turf Toe Terry looking?
You know what? I was talking to a Commanders fan last night, and he said Terry McLaurin has, like, not been seen since then. Like, not been heard of.
I don't know.
So, I don't know.
Was it turf toe, ankle? I think it was an ankle.
It was a toe, I believe, okay. Yeah.
I missed.
Again, I don't know. Like,
I thought it was an ankle.
I mean, by all accounts, turf toe is horrible.
It is. It really is. I've had it. It's brutal.
It's brutal. Like, you cannot walk.
He was in a boot tough. On Tuesday. The old boot. So, man, I don't know. Here's the thing, though. My Commanders are playing the Arizona Cardinals week one. Have you been keeping up with what they've been doing, Marcus?
Right there.
The Cardinals?
Yeah.
Not a lot.
They cut Colt McCoy.
Oh, man.
Kyler Murray's not ready. So they picked up Joshua Dobbs, and it looks like their starting quarterback is going to be a guy. Let me pull up his stats from ECU Houston last year, because I'm sure he had some good ones. Clayton Tune. The Houston quarterback
is starting,
is in line to be their week one starter against the Commanders.
Mm.
I don't think I've ever seen this kind of blatant tanking in football before.
It is Marlins-esque.
We see it in basketball. We see it in baseball. Clayton Tune against ECU last year, by the way, 32 of 44, 435, 4 touchdowns. Pretty good game.
That's good.
So they're tanking for Caleb Williams, I guess.
It could be. It could be.
But they traded Isaiah Simmons to the Giants.
They traded off all their talent, just about.
Yeah.
They've still got James Conner, Hollywood Brown, Rondell Moore.
Yeah.
Zach Ertz. Does he still play for him?
I believe so.
I think he's out or something, yeah. I believe.
But
yes.
Starting Clayton Tune and not, you know, picking up another quarterback, it tells me that they don't have much interest in winning this year.
Bold move, Cotton.
Yeah. Mm. Look, I said it when the schedule came out. The worst week one game in the NFL
is the Commanders-Cardinals.
It's Commanders-Cardinals.
It's gross.
You got to be a real sick SOB to be interested in that.
That is the NFL sickos
and
game.
And I am that sick guy.
That's the sickos game of the week.
Hey.
I'm that guy, pal.
I'll be paying attention, too.
Clip. Marcus, don't humor me.
I'm going to be. I'm serious.
I don't want you to give me a pity watch.
No, I'm serious. I'm serious.
You're going to be at tiebreakers, right?
Yes.
All right. Yeah. There's going to so be.
I think that's going to be a very. Your team is going to be very interesting this year.
I really do. I hope so. I agree with that.
In a good way.
There's going to be. How many week one games are there this year? 8 at 1 o'clock? How many 1 o'clockers? Let's see. Let me pull it up real quick. 2, 4, 6, 8. 8 1 o'clock games, Marcus, and they're all on different TVs.
Yeah.
You're telling me your attention's going to be on Washington and Arizona.
Yeah, now don't.
What
don't,
are my
don't
other
don't
options?
Mistake my words. Those words did not come out of my mouth.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough.
I said they're going to be interesting to watch.
Okay,
so I'll be watching there. I'll be watching there. Yeah, yeah.
You're going to have that. It's you're going to go through your progressions.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
Hey, look,
and then when they're in the red zone slash score zone.
Yeah.
I'm going to be paying attention to see how Sam Howell handles that.
I'm excited to see what he can do. If you or Jason need help on, see, I'm a professional at watching football on TVs at bars. If y'all need help, I'll give you some tips.
Okay.
Y'all get it done on the field. I'm a pro at knowing where the games are, the best sight lines, the best seat to get at the table.
Oh, absolutely.
You got to plan.
Absolutely.
I got you covered there.
And then for me, like, I may get caught up on the Washington game for sure. So you might have to say, hey, well, you might not, but Jason or somebody is going to have to say, hey, man, look
there's other
there.
Games there's going on. There's better games than Clayton Tune on right now, Mark.
Clayton Tune versus Sam Howell.
Hey,
look, I don't like the way you said Sam Howell.
I'm a Sam Howell fan this year.
Those guys are there for a reason. They've done a great job of getting to that point. So he has an opportunity. So I feel he's gonna take advantage of it. I do.
We'll talk more about it next week.
Unlucky, not good for you, but
we'll see. We'll see. We'll talk more next week. But I saw something cool on a college football podcast, where they did a draft of the time slots. You get a noon game, an afternoon game, and a night game. It was pretty cool. And you like build your
schedule,
your perfect football schedule for the Saturday.
I like it.
But
like to do the same for Sunday.
Well, I'm looking at NFL, so best 1 o'clock game is not Panthers Falcons, although division game's always interesting. Bengals Browns, pretty good matchup, division game. Still not the best. Jags Colts is up there with Washington Arizona as a worst matchup. Bucks Vikings is an ugly matchup. Titans Saints is not.
Yeah, there's some unattractive stuff.
All right, 49ers at Steelers.
That's
the best game because your only other option,
1 o'clock.
Your only other option is Houston Baltimore. It's 49ers Steelers, easy, right?
Yeah, yeah. And that's probably what we'll get here in Eastern NC. We get a lot of Steelers games.
Ooh. I can't wait till that map. The map comes out every Tuesday or Wednesday.
Yes. I love it.
I love looking at that coverage map and getting upset that Washington's not on local TV. So let's see. Glenn, you ain't watching that game because it's on Fox, buddy. You'll be watching the Panthers Falcons.
That's true.
What's the status of Burrow? Is he going to be ready for week one?
He's going to play.
Week one? If he is, then I would say that's going to be the game to watch.
It's a big game.
Yeah. I would say
Browns Bengals.
Browns Bengals, yeah.
Depending on what you think of the Browns this year.
Yeah.
Which I think they can be I like that whole division.
I almost think that the entire 1 o'clock slate is like a personal interest slate versus
your team slate.
Yeah, versus like a matchup slate.
Well, let's see. Let's go to the 4:25s and 4 o'clocks. You've got Packers Bears. Interesting game.
That's a good game. Yeah.
Kind of a big game for both of those teams early. Raiders Broncos.
Yeah.
Eagles Patriots.
Yeah.
Dolphins Chargers will be fun. That's a fun game.
Yes.
Great uniforms.
High scoring.
A lot of points.
Yes, sir.
The total for that game is 51.
Ooh.
And Rams Seahawks looks like a dud on paper to me. And then guess what, America?
Mm.
You've got
Cowboys
NFC East on Sunday Night Football.
You know it.
Like always, Cowboys and Giants. Ellerby, you want us to take a quick break or you want to come in right now? We'll take a break. We got a legend in the Pirate Radio studios, Ken Knox from Chairman of the Board. So we're going to have ECU Hall of Famer Marcus Crandall and a quick word from Music Hall of Famer Ken Knox from Chairman of the Board. When we return, Pirate Radio Live, back with you after this.
Are you ready to fall into beauty? Mark your calendar for October 2nd through the 6th
to take advantage of the savings on all of Beauty Bar MediSpa's services and products. Don't wait for the sale. Save time and money by scheduling your free consultation now. You can trust the licensed professionals at Beauty Bar MediSpa for amazing and natural looking results. Schedule your free consultation today and mark your calendar to Fall into Beauty, October 2nd through the 6th. BeautyBarMediSpa.com, Greenville.
Pizza, subs, slice, ice.
Jenny, what are you doing?
Just letting the Pirate Nation know that Cucinella's is now open in downtown Greenville, across from Sub Dogs. Did you know Cucinella's is open every day with $6 lunch specials, slices all day, beer, wine, and their famous homemade gelato? Plus, if you're busy, use DoorDash for Cucinella's delivery, and Cucinella's is open late night, Friday and Saturday. Cucinella's on Fifth Street in downtown Greenville. Go Pirates!
Save a load on a new John Deere compact utility tractor and loader from Quality Equipment. It's never been easier to get the best brand on the market at an unbeatable cash price or with great financing at our lowest ever monthly payment. Now is the time to get that tractor package you've been dreaming of to get your next job done right. Stop by one of our 36 locations in North Carolina, South Carolina, and Virginia, or visit us online at qualityequip.com.
This is Talbot Green with Integrity Home Mortgage. Are you ready and pre-approved if the home you want to purchase comes for sale today? This is a very important step when trying to purchase a home in the current market. Integrity Home Mortgage offers a wide variety of loan programs. Our team of Talbot Green, Braxton Green, and Joanne Weir has over 50 years of experience and is committed to providing you with the superior customer service you deserve.
To get started, call me, Braxton Green, at 526-8260.
Braxton Green and MLS 222-3878. For informational purposes only. Integrity Home Mortgage Corporation is equal housing lender, NMLS 208516.
Have you ever seen those exotic aquariums like the guys do in Las Vegas on television? You ever thought about having one of these aquariums in your business? It's more affordable than you think. This is Hal Pruitt with rentafishtank.com. We can make having an aquarium in your business turnkey with no work, cleaning, or hassles for you. Rentafishtank.com creates a relaxing atmosphere and keeps children occupied. Rentafishtank.com already services many dental, pediatric, and doctor offices, plus hospitals and senior living centers. Check us out at rentafishtank.com.
Hey Pirate Nation, this is Scott Harris with RE/MAX Preferred Realty. I've been in Greenville over 25 years. I'm a proud graduate of ECU. If you're looking to buy or sell a home, then give me a call today and let me help make your real estate process fun and easy. I keep it simple and explain the process every step of the way. My goals are your goals. There are no long-term contracts, and you always deal with me from start to finish. The right home starts with the right agent. Call me, Scott Harris, at 347-1857. Go Pirates!
Hi Pirates, this is Holden Ehlers. As I enter in a new season of life, it is still important to have a great team behind me. Whether you're going away to school for the first time, getting married, starting a family, or planning for your golden years, the choices can seem overwhelming and confusing. Let the team at Buck Insurance Agency make it easy as you enter into your next season. They have been helping people just like us for over 30 years. Give the Buck Insurance Agency a call today at 877-357-1966. Go Pirates!
Already planning for some fun in the sun? Don't forget to fill your cooler with the smooth and refreshing taste of Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Twisted Tea tastes like real iced tea because it's made with real brewed tea. And with 5% alcohol, Twisted Tea is there to turn things up all day long. Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Look for it in the bright yellow cans. Keep it twisted.
This is Tubular Company, Cincinnati, Ohio. Please drink responsibly.
Pirate Radio.
You know, if you're going to put your name on something, it better be your best work.
The voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 2 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by Beauty Bar MediSpa. Do you want to get rid of wrinkles, tighten and lift your skin, smooth your skin texture, erase veins and brown spots, and get rid of unwanted hair? Are you interested in Botox or filler? Visit BeautyBarMediSpa.com to set up a free consultation. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Be sure to visit one of ECU graduate Brandon Tate's U.S. Cellular locations and experience the highest standard of customer service. The purpose of the Atlantic Wireless store experience is to inform, illuminate, and inspire. Find the location near you at AtlanticWireless.com. Atlantic Wireless, we go beyond the call. Now let's head back into PRL. Here's Clip.
All right, back with you, Pirate Radio Live. We are inside of 3 hours away from the Pirate Radio football kickoff party, and I am bookended by legends at the moment. Marcus Crandall to my right and Ken Knox to my left from Chairman of the Board. Ellerby hanging out as well. And, man, Ken, great to have you in Greenville. Going to be a fun party tonight, man.
Man, I tell you what, I love what you guys do. I like this.
We should let's merge. The Chairman of the Board, Pirate Radio. How about that?
There you go. I love the sound of that.
Clip likes to sing occasionally.
I sure do.
Oh, but how about the Hall of Famer?
Sing?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know about singing now. Yeah. You don't want me to sing, but I like music, though. I love
okay, that's
music.
Good.
Yes,
so you asked me the question of... What'd you ask me?
What was my question? I think we're going to have fun tonight.
We're
going to
have
question.
Fun.
That was more of a statement than a question.
Okay, cool. Yeah, it's going to be great tonight. We feel at home every time we come to Greenville. You know, every chance we get, you know, General Danny and myself, we would love coming to the attic. Back in the day.
We're not that far from it.
Yep.
Yeah, it's down the street, right?
We were just walking down Fifth Street there, and you were kind of, the hotel's going up. A lot of changes over the years since you guys. When do you think your first appearance in Greenville was?
Ooh, probably mid-'80s.
Yeah.
Yeah, something like mid-'80s. And we found a niche market at the attic. So we were like there every... Man, probably felt like every weekend.
It did. It did. It seemed like y'all were headlining that Saturday night. It was the Chairman of the Board weekend. At least twice a semester, it felt like.
Oh, yeah. So as a kid, when we talked to you on the phone, I saw you at the Watermelon Festival all the time. You're at the attic. Oh, yeah. I guess back then, I just assumed you guys like lived down the road or something. But where were y'all based out of when you
back
weren't
then,
on the road? Yeah.
In the early days, we were based out of Detroit.
Yeah.
That's still home. I'm not going to talk of football about Michigan and Pirates, but anyway, I'm pulling for both of them.
There you go. Pulling cool. for a good game.
Yeah. I understand that.
Yeah. But we were out of Detroit, and then we came to Charlotte. We had a record label there in Charlotte called Surfside Records, and we had a booking agency called General Entertainment, named after General.
He's the man.
Yeah. So, man, we love Greenville. Is this called G-Town or?
G-Vegas.
Near G-Vegas.
Yes.
Yeah. It's going to be called Chairman of the Board Town tonight.
Uh-oh.
That's what it's going to be called. So excited to finally get to party weekend, football weekend. We've been talking about it so long, and really looking forward to your appearance at the State Theater. There's a few tickets left that people can get the door. Everybody was texting and calling us when they saw the hurricane coming in, and I talked to you yesterday. I was like, man, there's going to be sunny skies. We're going to be clear by party time, and that's the way it is right now. So
and you were right.
And I just took a good guess. I was doing a lot of praying and hoping. So, but we're excited about having you at the State Theater tonight. It's going to be a lot of fun. Listen. Starts at 7:00.
Hey, Pirates kickoff. We're ready. You know, Chairman of the Board, the executives. We thought about this all on the whole way down. Hey, how are we going to handle all these people? All the fun.
How you going to handle all these Pirates?
All these Pirates, yeah. But we're looking forward tonight. And like you said, there's a few tickets left. Come on down. The weather's great. I'm looking out the window now. It's sunshiny.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's 79.
It's one of the nicest days we've had in a long time here. That's for sure.
Well, here's the thing. School was canceled in Pitt County today. So you've been at home with your kids all day. It's time to check out and come out and have some fun tonight and kick off football season.
Absolutely.
So it's going to be a lot of fun. Clip, you mentioned 2019 Hall of Famer right here and Ken Knox for the North Carolina Music.
There you go.
And then 2022.
Actually, 1999.
Okay. Yeah. I thought you said 20.
And 2022.
Congrats.
Yes.
A lot of Hall of Fame greatness right here amongst us, Clip.
I'm still waiting for an invite to some Hall of Fame. I'm not sure who's going to be calling.
We have a big hall out in the Pirate Radio studio. And we can call you famous when you stand in it, maybe. How about that?
There you go.
It works.
I like hanging out with Hall of Famers. It's cool. Ken, this will be my first time seeing... I guess the new iteration of Chairman of the Board. So, for folks for like me that has not seen the group in a while since the passing of the legends that were your brothers there. You know, same kind of fun music, obviously, same songs, same. Should I not notice a difference tonight when I see you guys?
You shouldn't, because one thing General used to say, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. So we're still bringing that same energy and the songs, and we may have one or two new songs. But that was one thing that General asked me to promise him, was to keep the legacy going. And I think with the crew that I have, those guys been with me 13 years, some 10 years.
Man.
So it's going to be great, man. I'm excited. Really am.
Are you really excited? Because I talked to you earlier this week that it's indoors at the State Theater. You were outside at Greensboro this week, and it about knocked you out of commission. It was Greensboro almost did a number on us this week, worse than the hurricane. Really,
you know what Jonathan said? Don't die on me before you get there. I said, what? Yeah, man, it was so hot outside. I had a light heat stroke.
Oh, was that?
Man.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
And it's like, oh, boy, I'm so glad we're indoors for the next 2 days. Because tomorrow we're doing a private event, and it's indoors. So I get 2 days inside. Then next week, we're in Tennessee, and that's outside. And, oh, God. But anyway.
Awesome.
You need to do some contract work and put some clauses in there.
Uh-oh.
Hey, so the Pirates are traveling to Michigan. I know what that's like as far as coming from one place to going to the next on a long road trip. What's a road trip like for you all?
Ooh. What's a road trip like?
Yeah, like going all these different places, and you know, you're going to Greenville, Greensboro, and all the different places
cool,
around
man.
The world.
You know? But my favorite road trip is when we go to the UK. Now, that's a road trip.
All right, okay.
Yeah.
You told us, I was kind of surprised that how international Chairman of the Board is, and the foreign fans love the beach music.
They love the beach music. I mean, they listen to all the jocks that played the Carolina beach music. And so their curiosity was up. And but really, that's a fun tour. The next time we go over, I'm going to try to make it where we could have some of the fans come over. Believe it or not, in 2018, we met some fans from Wilson, North Carolina was there.
Wow.
I said, what?
Your ears were burning.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Stuff. Yeah. Hey, where y'all? Where you from? They said, Wilson, North Carolina. Y'all. I said, oh my God.
We need to do that, a little European vacation awesome. With Chairman of the Board.
Yeah. Have you ever done like a beach music cruise or a chairman cruise or something?
We got one coming up.
Yeah, that's awesome.
In October of next year, we have a Chairman of the Board cruise.
Man, that's cool.
All right, well, you need to let us know.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to let you know. I'd like to see you guys on it.
Yeah. we need to confer with the ECU football schedule, too. So,
that is true. October.
We need an away game. At least we can do it. Maybe do our pregame show on the cruise ship. But Marcus liked that idea.
That'd be nice. I don't know about that now.
Awesome stuff. Ken Knox joining us. Going to be a party tonight at the State Theater. Going to be a lot of fun.
Absolutely. Yeah, we'll be.
Cam, we're excited. I know you got to go do sound check. Anything else you want to tell the Pirate Nation before we see them all tonight at the State Theater?
Let's go, Pirates!
All right.
And we got forever. You're in our show open from here till the end of time when you said, East Carolina girls, the best in the world. So when we come on the air, we have your quote playing.
God,
so that was a perfect quote.
Yes.
Love awesome. It. All right. Thanks, Ken Ellerby. We'll see y'all in a little while.
Yeah, come on down to the State Theater. It's going to be a blast.
We got more with Marcus Crandall. We'll hear a little bit of what Donnie Kirkpatrick had to say yesterday, ECU offensive coordinator, when we return Pirate Radio Live on a Thursday. Back with you after this.
Here at Brown & Wood with Jeff Stein. It's summertime, and Jeff, you guys have a new car wash.
We do. We put in a brand new car wash just for the customer. So when you come in, get your vehicle serviced, we wash, dry, vacuum your car for free. It's state-of-the-art, but free to the customer.
And this summer, you have an AC special.
It's summertime. Air conditioning units are breaking left and right. But guess what? At Brown & Wood, all summer, I have free diagnostics on all air conditioning issues. Only at Brown & Wood.
The time to save is now during Bostick Sugg Furniture's incredible Labor Day savings event. Low, low prices on in-stock furniture and mattresses ready for immediate delivery. Look for hot buy savings store-wide on Lazy Boy recliners, sofas, and sectionals. Experience your best sleep and save on a comfortable new mattress. Plus, get up to 60 months special financing. It's the biggest sale of the season with the lowest prices of the season. The Labor Day savings event on now at Bostick Sugg Furniture.
And then it was two seagulls.
We're here for the booty.
Party?
Pirate Water is here. Go to drinkpiratewater.com to find Pirate Water in a location near you.
We're going planking!
Pirate Water is here. 21 and older, please drink responsibly.
Hey, Pirate Nation, Lindsey Gray here with Carolina Caliber. In 1960, my granddaddy started his firearm business right here in Eastern NC. Still family owned and operated, we have the area's largest selection for outdoor shooting sports and accessories and are one of the nation's top firearm dealers. At Carolina Caliber, we have everything you need from hunting, home defense, and personal protection, including a wide variety for ladies and youth. We buy, sell, and trade. It's a time-honored tradition. Visit us at Carolina Caliber on Fire Tower Road in Winterville.
East Coast Grading and Utilities is your source for clearing, hauling dirt, and concrete work. East Coast Grading and Utilities handles all sewer and water issues as well.
I'm David Vaughn. Whether it's putting in a new subdivision or helping you with any and all of your drainage problems, I can get the job done. Call me at 531-7494.
No job is too big or too small. East Coast Grading and Utilities. Friends helping friends. 531-7494. For East Coast Grading and Utilities.
It's bow time. Chicken or biscuits? That's an impossible choice. How can you decide between Bojangles' perfectly crispy, boldly seasoned chicken or their fluffy, made-from-scratch buttermilk biscuits? Well, the good news is you don't have to. With a Cajun chicken filet biscuit, you get the best of both worlds. An all-white meat chicken breast marinated with a bold blend of seasonings and served up on a fluffy, golden buttermilk biscuit. When it comes to real-deal Southern flavor, there's no reason you can't have it all. Order a Cajun chicken filet biscuit today. It's bow time.
This is a great time to shop Russell's in downtown Washington. Hi, it's Russell, and we have a lot going on at the store. All of our women's summer merchandise is now one half price. All of our summer men's apparel is reduced 30 to 50%. This is a great time to save big and get a preview of fall. Selection and sizes are still good. Football season is fast approaching, and we want to be your clothing source for game day, so keep us in mind. It's all about you, our pirate-loving friends at Russell's in downtown Washington.
Picking football games against the spread is hard. Shopping at the Appliances Superstore is easy. This is Frank Lee from the Appliances Superstore, and right now we're having a big sale with 50% off open box French door refrigerators. Did you know we also offer delivery and setup when you shop with us? And if we don't have what you want, we will make a special order for you. The Appliances Superstore, off 264 behind the new DMV, or shop us online, appliancessuperstore.com. Remember, we make buying appliances easy at the Appliances Superstore.
This is Coach Gary Overton, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 2 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by Beauty Bar Medispa. Do you want to get rid of wrinkles, tighten and lift your skin, smooth your skin texture, erase veins and brown spots, and get rid of unwanted hair? Are you interested in Botox or filler? Visit BeautyBarMedispa.com to set up a free consultation. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Fifth Street Hardware Restaurant and Tap Room is your favorite place in downtown Greenville for lunch, dinner, or drinks with friends. Fifth Street serves lunch and dinner Tuesday through Sunday, plus brunch starting at 10:30 on Saturdays and Sundays. You can follow Fifth Street on Instagram for the latest events and specials. Fifth Street Hardware Restaurant and Tap Room, right beside the State Theater in downtown Greenville. Now let's head back in to PRL. Here's Clip.
All right, back with you, Pirate Radio Live. Man, awesome having Ken Knox in the Pirate Radio studios. Brings back a lot of great memories of chairman of the board, and make some new memories tonight. And Marcus, this will kind of be your introduction to chairman of the board,
indeed,
right?
Yes, indeed, man. Yeah. Yes, indeed. Never listened to him. Although I listened, I probably did back in the day. Because
you're going
to
know some songs,
you know,
definitely.
I listened to, I've heard of and listened to, not on a religious basis, but I did listen to, you know, some Beach Boys and that kind of music back then and when I was growing up. But yeah, it's gonna be nice. I'm looking forward to it.
Well, Marcus is taking down a coffee, and I think he's gonna pop a Celsius that a shot.
I'm
so
gonna be bouncing off the walls in here, man.
Watch out.
Ooh.
Cram Man's gonna be dancing tonight. And again, Celsius, the sponsor of our watch party. And we're going to need some energy, Marcus, because a 4-hour pregame show, 3+ hour game, and the fifth quarter goes until the last caller is served. So it is going to be a long Saturday and a fun Saturday with the Pirate Nation. Looking forward to your calls on the U.S. Sailor fifth quarter call-in show, and really excited. I said earlier in the show, callers, take it easy on Marcus and Jason for their first game. Let's ease them into it before we get too crazy. But man, gonna be a lot of fun coming up on Saturday.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it, Pirate fans. And although we have a tough task ahead of us, I think it's just gonna be an exciting atmosphere for the ones that are traveling there. It's going to be nice for us to see us going against the Wolverines for sure as we're watching.
Jamie says, who's on Chandler watch duty tonight to make sure he stays out of trouble? Well, I won't be drinking, so I'll keep an eye on him. We'll have Mama Shirley there. Marcus is always...
You got four eyes on you.
Yeah, so Chandler better watch it because we got a lot of eyeballs on him tonight. But you know what? I'm going to be the cool dad, Chandler, and I'm going to say, have fun, son. Just don't get in trouble. Just don't drive. You ain't driving, right? Hey, your daddy's coming, ain't he? Old Clark Honeycutt's coming. So we'll have a few Honeycutts in the house tonight. Michael Winstead's in the chat. Michael, I don't know if you heard earlier, but I did send your boy Isaiah a congratulatory text last night, and he's not satisfied, but congratulations to Isaiah Winstead making the 49ers practice squad. All the Pirates that are either on the team or on the practice squad, awesome stuff. And looking forward to an NFL season, which we'll get into more next week. Pike is checking in from North Myrtle Beach. Good to see you, Pike, and good to see all the folks in the chat. Johnny says, love chairman of the board. Saw them on campus on the mall in the mid-80s. They have been doing it a long time. Kenny Curlings says, Giants beat the Cowboys week one, 35-17. All right. He also says, what years did Marcus play at Roanoke High School? When did you play, Marcus?
Oh, I graduated in 92.
92.
Yep.
All right. There you go. There are the years. All right. Let's hear what Donnie Kirkpatrick had to say. And I want to ask Marcus about no depth chart, no starting quarterback named, his thoughts on it. But let's hear what ECU offensive coordinator Donnie Kirkpatrick had to say on Wednesday.
Well, Donnie, what concerns you? What concerns you the most about Michigan, if you can pinpoint one thing, we can have a defense?
Their players. They got really good players. You know, defensively, I think they gave up 16 points a game last year. Now, that was last year's team. I get that. But they got most of them returning. They did lose some players. But, you know, programs like that, they just reload. I think they've lost, what, 3 games in 2 years or something like that. So they're used to winning. They're used to having success. That means that they're recruiting well. And they just have outstanding talent. I mean, they don't do anything that's so, okay, wow, you know, what scheme is that? They have good schemes. You know, Coach Minter does a great job. He's got NFL experience. They've got a lot of NFL stuff in. But you know, that's not what worries you. What worries you is their defensive line can just explode off the ball and just throw the offensive lineman down and go make the tackle. And then there's like four other guys there when they make the tackle as well. They do a nice job with the interceptions. A lot of tip balls. I tell you what, you better not tip the ball, you know, as a receiver, because they do a great job of breaking on the ball and getting the turnovers, setting the offense up, you know, for success. So, a lot of concerns. Yeah, a lot of concerns. Really, a lot of respect for them.
You're looking for any edge you can get here. Is one of them that they haven't seen a lot of Mason Garcia, Alex Flynn, and this East Carolina offense in particular on film?
Well, they haven't, you know, and so that, I guess that's something maybe they're trying to research. You know, I don't know that that's a positive for us. That means our guys haven't been playing very much. You know, it's probably better to have experience like that. But, you know, we're looking for every way you can. We're looking for any kind of advantage. And, you know, you go in with a plan. That may hold true. The thing about first games, it's always a little crazy anyhow. You're kind of sparring at the beginning trying to figure out, you know, is that the same team? Like I say, we opened up with North Carolina State last year, and they had been a great defense the year before. We were expecting a really good defense, which they turned out to be. But you're still getting in there trying to figure out, have they stayed with the same scheme? Have they put in new things? Have they moved people around? And usually they have, and they had, and I'm sure Michigan will have some new things for us as well like that. So I think our guys will be excited. You know, I think that's maybe an edge. I don't know how – I mean, they'll be excited to play. They're probably not – their fans are probably not thinking, wow, we're playing East Carolina. You know, whereas our fans and our players are hearing, hey, y'all are going to play Michigan. This is pretty cool. So if anything, hopefully we'll be excited. Maybe we'll be more excited than them if that's possible.
Coach, we tried to get out of Coach Houston who's going to play and who's going to be here and there, and we didn't really succeed in that. So,
wow, y'all are not very good at this. So, what the heck, huh?
How does the offense change based on your personnel?
You know, the thing about, I know the depth chart things out there, and of course Michigan's not been giving out one, I guess, for years. You know, that's a Harbaugh thing, and I know, you know, once – Lord Saban comes out with something like that, then it's going to become a rule, I guess, probably, that you don't do depth charts, you know, like that. So, but the game has changed so much anyhow because everybody's personnel and things now. It looks like a hockey game out there anyhow. You know, there's side changes or whatever that thing is. So, you know, we have 10 personnel, you have 11 personnel, you have 13 personnel, you have 20 personnel. But now even you have 11 Jari. You know, and you have 11 juice, and you have, okay, I want this personnel, but I want this player in to make sure, you know, or I want to play these two guys, though they may be listed at the same position, because, you know, you're a guard, you're a forward, you're a center, you know, you're an infielder, whatever you are now. It's getting more like that. You're a mid-infielder, you know what I'm saying, or you're a pitcher, but you might start, you might not start. Everybody's doing multiple things. The game has got a lot more open, a lot more basketball-like, you know, like that. A lot of guys can bring the ball down to court now, you know what I'm saying? So it really is kind of hard to make a depth chart out because you don't know who really deserves to be, like, the starter, I guess. And I know that's a big deal. It was a big deal to me, you know, when I was playing. It was a big deal to your mom, I guess, probably more than you are, like that. But now you'd say, well, who's starting the game? At a lot of positions, you'd say, well, where's the ball? What's the score? You know, do we have it on the -3? You know what I'm saying? Are we starting coming out? Well, that means we're going to be in a different personnel because you got a game plan that. Did we run the kickoff back across midfield? Okay, now we're in a sudden change. Okay, the coordinator, he might be going to blitz more in that situation. All right, we're in this personnel. So it's getting like that. Now, you know, the quarterback thing, probably not quite to that extent. What I think, you know, and Coach is kind of saying is, you know, we know what we're going to do, and you guys know what we're going to do. We really are prepared to play three quarterbacks. And in a game like this, I'm not saying this is a game it doesn't matter, but I'm pretty sure John Gilbert got the money up front. Okay, I hope he did anyhow. I'm sure he got the money. Okay, so we can let this thing roll. You know what I'm saying? We can go play to win, which we're always going to play to win the game. But you'd be crazy not to, if you had a chance to do something, you know, play another guy. I mean, who knows? Why can't you play two quarterbacks in the same thing? Yeah, why not? You know what I'm saying? If there's a play that would be cool to do, this is the time to do it. You know, I don't know if it's time to do it when you're playing for the conference championship or the home opener, but this is the time to go do that.
Last week you said you were going to get with, I guess, Coach Mogridge and kind of narrow down that offensive line. How's that going the last week? And you found a 5-year comfortable with
it? I think we've probably separated up front that who's going to play the majority. Coach Mogridge is from the school, and I am too, that we'd like to play more offensive linemen. In the past 4 years since we've been here, it's been, do we have five today? You know what I'm saying? You know, I still remember being at Navy, and we're coming out for the kickoff, and they're saying, hey, by the way, Noah's out. And I said, he's out where? Yeah, he's out of the game. We're like, what are we going to do now? We have nobody else, you know what I'm saying? We have to move the left guard over to right tackle or something like that. We have good depth now as far as numbers. The strength of our offense probably, and I've said this before, may not be in. We got some name guys. We don't have Holt Mailers, okay, who everybody knows about the scene. We don't have the little dude that ran all over everybody again, you know, too. We don't have some of those names. We don't have CJ. But we've got a lot of different guys, you know what I'm saying? So if one guy's not on that day, we have more options, you know what I'm saying? Now, eventually, I hope somebody starts to separate and becomes a star, like, you know, Isaiah did, you know what I'm saying, like CJ did, like Ryan Jones did. But right now, it's more of, we got a bunch of guys, but we got more guys, you know, so practice right now. We're playing more guys. We're working more guys. I hope that keeps us fresher, too, throughout the year. That could be the other advantage. Maybe not necessarily in this game. They're pretty deep, I think. But I think throughout the season it could be.
Going off that, it's part of it, too, at this point. Y'all just have to get out there and see
who's going to step up in a game situation and kind of ride the high hand, maybe?
That's the whole nerve-wracking part. But I guess in a way it's kind of the fun part, too, like I say. You know, it's more fun when you come down and you get that extra Christmas present you didn't know you're getting. So, you know, we're out there practicing and guys are doing good and quarterbacks are looking good, you know, but I'm thinking like, okay, you know, when we do that in a game, it counts. You know what I'm saying? Batting practice is one thing, hitting one out in a game, that's a little bit different. So the good players usually come to the top, the bigger the situation, the bigger the game, you know what I'm saying? But we're getting ready to find out because we're going to get tested just like we did last year, though. I mean, North Carolina State proved to be one of the best defenses in the country, you know, throughout the season. And that was after they lost their quarterback. They didn't do much offensively either. They kept putting people down. So we'll have another tough challenge like that. You know, we'd love to be playing at home. You know what I'm saying? I wish we were playing here. We're playing up there. But, again, I don't know. Maybe that's going to be a better thing. It'll be fun.
All right, there is Donnie Kirkpatrick. You can see that in its entirety on our social media accounts. A couple of things, Marcus. I liked the way he talked about the metaphor sparring in week one, because you go all off season, and as I said earlier, ECU players know Michigan. They've watched the film, but they don't know what Michigan's adding to that defense. Michigan doesn't know hardly anything about this offense, so ECU does have the elements of surprise there. But do you get what he's saying there? Do you remember that kind of early in the year where you're kind of wait, all right, who's going to throw the first punch? What are they doing on defense? We got to go back to the sidelines, talk about that, all those things going on.
Absolutely. You know, you watch a boxer in the ring and they're kind of, you know, trying to figure out the rank and how they're moving around and trying to pretty much line up the opponent, so to speak, right? And so, yes.
Setting up something.
Absolutely. Kind of thing. Trying to set up the knockout punch, so to speak. And but that's what you do get, especially when two teams really don't know each other that well, other than what they have seen on film, hadn't played each other, and so you're going to get that early on. And so for us, I think it's going to be very important that we, I know we're going to expand on this on Saturday, but keep our composure because they're going to come and hit us in the mouth, and we got to just be ready to get back up and go again.
He also said no big names, but a lot of guys, and he said some of these guys will eventually be big names. They're gonna grow into that star role, that go-to guy for East Carolina. But entering week one, they're gonna figure out who it is when the lights come on. And that has been the kind of mantra of this team, that they have the best depth they've ever had since Mike Houston's been here, but maybe not the star power, definitely not the star power that we had a year ago.
You know what? Those guys got to make themselves stars, right? I mean,
you weren't a star when you came in.
That's exactly what I was going to say. We went 5-6, 2-9, I got hurt, and then came back and nobody knew who East Carolina was. I mean, we had a great defense. I think, you know, we were holding people and stopping and playing some big games defensively, but offensively, we really weren't doing much. And so, again, just to kind of give those guys motivation, man, in regards to going out there and take this thing and giving your all. I know they are, but grasp the bull by the horns and take advantage of this opportunity.
What do you think of the publicly not releasing a depth chart? I don't know if that's kind of speaking of sparring, Michigan's not doing one, so we're not going to do one. But what about not coming out naming a starter? You know, what do you think?
Well, what it does is, you know, we already got a little bit of an advantage that Harbaugh is not going to be on the sidelines coaching, but he's going to be coaching up until then. But just another little, I guess, nugget, if you want to call it, to try and keep them unaware of what's going on.
If you don't have really, to name it, I guess, why?
That's right. Why? Why? Absolutely. They've done it year after year, or game after game.
And Lord Saban, as Donnie Kirkpatrick called it. Lord Saban. I like that yesterday.
You know, it really becomes just a mental thing, really.
Yeah.
And, you know, as far as trying to get that competitive edge. But, you know, you can't worry about those things. They're as you mentioned, or he mentioned, they're not going to Michigan's not going to name theirs as well, so it kind of goes both ways. But you know, if they don't know who the quarterback is, which is the king, so to speak, and or the queen, I should say, actually moving all around the place, they don't know how to defend the quarterback. And so
Mark,
a little less film.
Mark on YouTube, and we mentioned this earlier in the show, but he said that he has a Michigan fan customer who said they are missing 5 to 7 starters with injuries, mostly DBs. So second time we've mentioned DBs and them being out. Michael Winstead said, I'm confused. Donnie is the OC for football. What does basketball have to do with it? Donnie used basketball, baseball.
He used a lot of.
He just talks, man. He just gets going.
And but I get
it's hard to reel him in using those analogies. Yeah. Marcus, as a quarterback, now this would be double tough for you when you played because Steve Logan was the offensive guy. They're without their head coach, Michigan is. They're without their offensive coordinator as well. Mm-hmm. Could you argue that that's more important maybe than even the head coach? You got a new kind of play caller in there. Like that's, I don't know, that could cause more issue than Harbaugh not being there almost.
Yeah, it could, but just like Coach alluded to in regards to they got players. If you look at their roster, like they have a number of guys, I want to say about 10 of them, 10 to 15 in the top 100 of the pre-rankings in the league, but they're good.
Yeah, and think about it too. Last year, let's say Mike Houston and Donnie Kirkpatrick had to miss a game, Holton could run the offense. He'd That's been right. in it for so long. Now, if that happened this year and you're an inexperienced quarterback, it would be detrimental to Mason Garcia and ECU. But to your point, Michigan's got veterans.
Got a veteran.
Yeah.
They got a veteran at QB, got a veteran at the running back position, very deep there. And so, we just got to go in with a calm mentality, looking to go in there and looking for the upset and trying to find our way to get a win, man.
All right, we'll get your official prediction Saturday. We'll have plenty more time to talk about it.
Yes, we will.
Because we will be with you. Mark is going to hang out for a couple hours on the pregame.
Pregame.
Bud Light pregame tailgate.
Watching the
We'll be with you at the watch party brought to you by Celsius and after the game.
The post-game.
On the U.S. Sailor fifth quarter call-in show. And then we're going to have a sleepover that night. Just keep hanging out with each other, watching football all night. No, we'll be sick of each other by Saturday night, Marcus. We need a week off. But, man, it's going to be a lot of fun.
It will be.
We're going to feed you well. We got some breakfast from Harvey's rolling in.
All right.
We've got some lunch from Fifth Street Hardware, I believe, coming in as well. And wings over after the game.
Oh, man. Oh.
Here's the bad part,
Thank you,
Marcus.
Sponsors.
When you become one of us, you better work out or you'll end up fat like me. So I'm going to give you a warning on that. All right. Cram Man, good stuff.
Good job, man.
We'll see you Saturday.
Awesome. Looking forward to it.
No, I'll see you at the party.
Yeah.
And we'll talk to you again Saturday. For our YouTube and Facebook folks, we are signing off. Pirate Radio Live, we'll roll on Pirate Radio 92.7, 104.1, 1250, 930, online, pr927fm.com. But we are signing off of YouTube. So to the YouTube and Facebook fam, we'll see you guys Friday at 3 o'clock. But the show rolls on. Emory Hunt joining us. We're going to break down week one. We'll talk ECU, Michigan, and a lot more. That and more on the way. Pirate Radio Live on a Thursday. Back with you after this.